Back off! I was here first! Why, you looking to buy one? Oh, is he? Well, that's... See, I'd like to sell you one, but I don't, have any myself. I got part of a glove the wolves didn't chew too badly, though. I think it was a glove, anyway. I know, don't say it. I got cheated. I knew the guy who was here before me. He sold me this spot. Said he found giants and all kind of crazy valuables. He didn't mention that he'd taken everything but the bones and the dirt already. His name's Ferrin. Squirrely little bastard, if you ask me. Which you didn't, but I said it anyway. He was going to Orzammar, he said. I imagine he's gotten there by now. If you find him, tell him I sent you. It'll scare the piss out of him.
You have some kind of problem? Oh? What was this about? How sad it is to see a Grey Warden manipulated. But I have no time to straighten this out for you. Men, let's teach the Grey Warden a lesson about trust.
Enemies approaching!
My spell isn't done!
If we must fight, let us do it quickly! I must maintain!
That's a lot of blood.
I shall do it.
You're the Grey Warden, aren't you? Exactly who I was hoping to meet. I represent a collective of mages interested in going about their lives without the constant scrutiny of the Chantry. The collective is a self-policing guild of mages who simply want to be left alone. We mean no offense to the Chantry, but we would rather live on our own terms. Next to me, and in every major settlement, you will find an inconspicuous sack containing requests from mages all over the land who need the assistance of someone skillful and discreet. Thank you, my friend. We have agents in every major settlement to reward you for work done on behalf of the collective. Make us smile upon you.
Good day, and welcome to the Spoiled Princess. Is there something I can get for you? It was my father's idea. He ran the inn before me, and he named it for my sister. She was his little princess. Princess decided the country was too dull for her and moved to Denerim. More glamorous, she said. Well, she was found murdered, robbed of all the trinkets my father bought her with his hard-earned money. My father died of shock and heartbreak. Mother stopped eating, and I got the struggling inn. The name stuck. That's a story. Of course. What would you like?
Wow, I've never seen one of you knife ears dressed like the King of Ferelden before. You made good for yourself, eh? Oh, I don't mean no offense. I know I shoot my mouth off. I'm just not used to your kind, trussed up all fancy. Oh, there I go again. I don't mean nothing by it. I swear I should start over. I'm mighty pleased to be making your acquaintance, sir. Don't hold your breath. No one's been allowed across the lake for days. I'm the ferryman. Leastwise, I used to be. Poor old Kester. Out of a job. I don't got a clue. They wouldn't tell me. Gregor just came down and said, "Don't you worry, Kester. We got it all under control, we do." Didn't say nothing else. And then he puts Carol in charge of my boat. Lissy. Named for my grandmum, she was. He's Knight Commander of the Templars up in the tower. Good man. I told you, they didn't tell me nothing. And if I know their mages, I'm better off keeping out of their business. If I had to guess, I'd guess it had to do with magic. But the tower's always got something to do with magic. Don't look at me. I told you, I'm not the ferryman no more. Gregor's told me to stay here till it blows over. But I'm telling you, some storms don't blow over easy. Maybe you could at that. I'm sure your mind's all afire now, eh? I reckon it's good for them mages. Gather them all, learn them some proper magics. I know what they say about mages, but the Maker made them for a purpose. If you can't trust him, who can you trust? Oh, I can't say that. I'm lucky he's good enough to give me the time of day. The first enchanter's all right. He's polite as can be, but he's always a little distant, if you get my drift. But Gregor will stay to talk. I reckon he likes hearing from us common folk, you know? He's a man to be respected, that Gregor. All right. Keep safe, you hear?
You! You're not looking to get across to the tower, are you? Because I have strict orders not to let anyone pass. Oh, you're a Grey Warden, are you? Prove it. So I'm not good enough for you. Fine. See if you get into the tower on your own. Oh, really? You think Gregor would be upset with me for not letting you in? Wait, actually, he would. Good point. He's the big guy around here. I bet he could deal with one Grey Warden. Alleged Grey Warden. Well, you want that I should take you there now? Come along, I suppose.
And I want two men stationed within sight of the doors at all times. Do not open the doors without my express consent. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
The doors are barred. Are they keeping people out or in?
Now we wait and pray. Who are you? I explicitly told Carol not to bring anyone across the lake. We're dealing with a very delicate situation. You must leave for your own safety. I am weary of the Grey Warden's ceaseless need for men to fight the Darkspawn, but it is their right. You'll find no allies here. The Templars can spare no men, and the mages are indisposed. I shall speak plainly. The tower is no longer under our control. Abominations and demons stalk the tower's halls. The circle is lost. The tower has fallen. We don't know. We saw only demons, hunting Templars and mages alike. I realized we could not defeat them and told my men to flee. I have sent word to Denerim, calling for reinforcements and the right of annulment. The right of annulment gives Templars the authority to neutralize the mage circle. Completely.
The mages are probably already dead. Any abominations remaining in there must be dealt with, no matter what.
This situation is dire. There is no alternative. Everything in the tower must be destroyed so it can be made safe again. If any are still alive, the Maker himself has shielded them. No one could have survived those monstrous creatures. It is too painful to hope for survivors and find nothing. I assure you, an abomination is a force to be reckoned with, and you will face more than one. A word of caution. Once you cross that threshold, there is no turning back. The great doors must remain barred. I will open them for no one. until I have proof that it is safe. I will only believe it is over if the first enchanter stands before me and tells me it is so. If Irving has fallen, then the circle is lost and must be destroyed. May Andraste lend you her courage, whatever you decide.
I have a thought. We have an opportunity that I believe we should take advantage of. To the point. My mother was once divested of a particular grimoire by a most annoying Templar hunter. It occurred long before I was born, but even today, Flemeth speaks of the loss with great rage. With the Circle of Magi in such disarray, it occurs to me that this might be the perfect time to recover the tome from their possession, for surely it eventually ended up in their hands. Flemeth is a sorceress of legend, is she not? And her grimoire would be more than a mere curiosity to mages that daren't even glance towards the places my mother has walked for eons. No doubt 'tis considered something dangerous, perhaps best locked away somewhere dark, yes? And if not, then at least I know it does not exist. But there is no harm in looking, surely? 'Tis a book of spells, of the sort that Flemeth has dabbled with throughout her long life. 'Tis not the sort of thing that would benefit a mage of the standard variety. They were taught a different path. I, however, was taught by my mother. I know a way around the wards my mother would have placed on such a tome. I know the language that she would have written it in. I would find such a tome most useful. Useful in the way that it might increase my power. Useful in the way that I would become more useful to you. Does that not follow? Dangerous? All knowledge is potentially dangerous. If you have some fear of me such that I should not be allowed such knowledge, then by all means deprive me of it. I have no ulterior motive for seeking it, however. I did not think of it earlier. Truly, Mother has assumed for a long time that the tome was lost forever. I only remembered it now after thinking what treasures might be found in the Circle of Magi's tower now in its condition. Good. I am most interested to see its contents, should it be located. The grimoire is leather-bound and adorned with the symbol of a leafless tree, should you come across it. If not, however, then I shall simply put it out of my mind.
I wish this were over. We're running low on supplies, and I don't know how much longer we'll last. I certainly hope so. Are you here to trade, then?
I shall do it.
It's you. No, come no further. Grey Warden or no, I will strike you down where you stand. I am a mage of the Circle. More importantly, why are you here? The Templars would not let just anyone by. And you were told that the Circle was in no shape to help you, I suppose. So why did the Templars let you in? Do they plan to attack the tower now? So Gregor thinks the Circle is beyond hope. He probably assumes we are all dead. They abandoned us to our fate. But even trapped as we are, we have survived. If they invoke the right, however, we will not be able to stand against them. Let it suffice to say that we had something of a revolt on our hands, led by a mage named Uldred. When he returned from the battle at Ostagar, he tried to take over the Circle. As you can see, it didn't work out as he had planned. I don't know what became of Uldred, but I am certain all this is his doing. I will not lose the Circle to one man's pride and stupidity. I erected a barrier over the door leading to the rest of the tower, so nothing from inside could attack the children. You will not be able to enter the tower as long as the barrier holds, but I will dispel it if you join with me to save this Circle. Once Gregor sees that we have made the tower safe, I trust he will tell his men to back down. He is not unreasonable. Then our path is laid out before us. We must save Irving. Petra and Kenan will watch them. If we slay all the fiends we encounter on our way, none will get by to threaten the children. No, I know the tower, and I know what we face. And if the Circle is indeed lost, and all the mages dead, I would see this for myself.
You want us to assist this preachy schoolmistress to rescue these pathetic excuses for mages? They allow themselves to be corralled like cattle, mindless. Now their masters have chosen death for them, and I say, let them have it. Have it your way.
Petra, Kenan, look after the others. I will be back soon.
Wynn, are you sure you're all right? You were so badly hurt earlier. Maybe I should come along.
The others need your protection more. I will be all right. Stay here with them. Keep them safe and calm. Your confidence is refreshing, though you should make sure it does not blind you to your weaknesses. If you are ready, let us go end this. Yes? Is there something you wish to discuss? If not, we should hurry. Time is of the essence. Ah, a long story. It all started when I returned from Ostagar. I was at that ill-fated battle, and I survived barely. I was in no state to travel, so I stayed at Ostagar to recuperate and help the wounded. Uldred, on the other hand, left for the tower almost immediately. When I finally returned here, I found that Uldred had all but convinced the Circle to join Loghain, the man who nearly destroyed us all. I cannot fault the Circle, though. Uldred had a persuasive argument, and how could they have known what happened in Ostagar? That is my suspicion. Uldred always wanted power. Perhaps Loghain promised Uldred the position of First Enchanter once they had dealt with the Blight. Well, I told the First Enchanter Irving what Loghain did on the battlefield. I revealed him for the traitorous bastard he is. Irving said he would take care of it. He called a meeting to confront Uldred. But something must have gone wrong. I emerged from my quarters when I heard the screams. They were coming from the meeting room, and it wasn't long before I saw the first abomination running down a mage. It deteriorated quickly then. It must have, though I don't know for sure. The creatures came from that direction, as far as I could tell. Aldred. It's uncharitable of me to speak this way, but I never liked him. He was a squirrely, twitchy sort of person. He never mentored the apprentices, never taught. He didn't seem to care much for the Circle. Only his own advancement. I'm sure Aldred has some redeeming qualities. He probably has a perfectly good reason for not displaying them. You have seen the demons, haven't you? We will doubtless see more of those. But I fear the abominations more. They are no longer human, and are driven only by their lust for destruction. I hope you're right. Right now, when lives are at stake? Perhaps we should leave that for later. Besides, what is the point of that? One should let one's actions speak for themselves, and let others form their own opinions. Onward, then.
I don't suppose this is what you expected the Circle to be like, is it? I keep thinking this is our punishment for being mages. That's why the Templars have to do away with us. Their swords are like the Sword of Mercy that sent Andraste back to the Maker. Andraste only died because of man's foolishness and pride. We need to atone for this. We should let the Templars come. Only then can we be cleansed of our wickedness. I will pray. May we abandon our tainted bodies to find peace with the Maker.
It is good to see that some wardens survived. We are sorry for the loss of your comrades. You heard about Loghain. I would never have imagined the Tarn a traitor. Wynn was at Ostagar. She told us everything upon her return. But why speak of things past? Be careful in there, and stay safe.
Look after her, will you? I don't know if she's up to this, especially not after... I just worry. I was on my way down to the library when I heard screaming, and a demon came around the corner. Its eyes were afire with evil. I was certain it was my death come upon me. I think I screamed. I was so afraid. And then Wynn was there, in front of me, shielding me. It was light and fire, blood and chaos. When it was over, the demon was dead, but Wynn wasn't moving either. I was so afraid she was gone. As I moved to help her, she stirred and coughed. I don't know what I would have done if she had died for me. I know. I owe her too much. Just look after her, all right? She might be completely fine, but then again, maybe she didn't come away from that totally unharmed. Thank you. And thank you again for helping us.
Here we are. I'm somewhat amazed at myself for having kept it in place this long. It made me very weary at times, but I had to stay strong to keep us safe, be prepared for anything. I do not know what manner of beasts lurk beyond this barrier. Are you ready? All right. Be on your guard.
No quarter shall be given!
Quickly, fight!
It shall be done. It is begun. Shall be done. I shall do it. As you say. Shall be done. Very well. Shall be done.
Oh, this is rather awkward, what? I'm not supposed to be here. Not right at all. Oh, this is rather awkward, what? I'm not supposed to be here. Not right at all.
Please refrain from going into the stockroom. It is a mess, and I've not been able to get it into a state fit to be seen. I am called Owain, and I manage the Circle's magical stockroom. I was trying to tidy up, but there was little I could do. Of course, I am defenseless, and if I ran into one, I would surely perish. I tried to leave when things got quiet. That was when I encountered the barrier. Finding no other way out, I returned to work.
Owain, you should have said something. I would have opened the door for you.
The stockroom is familiar. I prefer to be here. I would prefer not to die. I would prefer it if the tower returned to the way it was. Perhaps Niall will succeed and save us all. I do not know, but he came here with several others and took the litany of Adrala.
But that protects from mind domination. Is blood magic at work here?
I do not know.
Niall was in the meeting. He would know. Blood magic. I was afraid of this. Blood magic could control us, too. Who knows what could happen then? We should find Niall. The litany will give us a fighting chance against any blood mages we encounter.
I wish you luck. Perhaps this will be over soon and things will return to the way they were. Goodbye.
As you say.
What are we doing?
Quiet, both of you.
Please, please don't kill me. I know I have no right to ask for mercy, but I didn't mean for this death and destruction. We were just trying to free ourselves. Aldred told us that the Circle would support Loghain, and Loghain would help us be free of the Chantry. You don't know what it was like. The Templars were watching. Always watching. It would be like talking to a brick wall. A brick wall that would rather you didn't exist in the first place. We thought, someone always has to take the first step. Force a change, no matter the cost.
Nothing is worth what you've done to this place.
And now Aldred's gone mad. And we are scattered, doomed to die at the hands of those who seek to right our wrongs. What else can I do? I'm trapped here. Please, if you spare me, I could escape and seek penance at the Chantry.
You know, they'll never take you. They're very picky about who they let in. Harlots, murderers, yes. Maleficarum, oh no.
I just want my life. Please. I'll find a way, please. I swear I'll do something good with my life. Thank you. The Maker will surely turn his eyes on you for your mercy.
It is begun. I shall do it.
Mages from before the Circle and before the Chantry held them in check.
Say. As you say.
Are the demons gone? Is it safe? I don't want to die. If you're sure it's safe, I could take a peek outside.
Yes. Oh, I have a crick in my back and my bum's gone numb. Oh, holy maker, look at this. Those demons didn't know what hit them, did they? Godwin, Mage of the Circle of Ferelden, at your service. There were demons everywhere, blocking my exit. I decided that the best thing to do in that situation was to hide and be very, very quiet. I just really want to be somewhere safe. I think I might stay here for now. Maybe go back into my closet for a little while. Thank you again for saving me. May we meet again in happier, less life-threatening times.
There's nothing here!
There must be something left. If we get out, we're gonna need gold. Aldred said...
Aldred's not here, is he? Keep your mouth shut, and we'll be right as rain.
Enemies approaching! Best be wary!
It shall be done. It is begun. It is begun. Come on!
peek. This is Irving's office. I half expected to find him here, but I suppose that's too much to hope for.
It shall be done.
Everyone's gone. Or dead. I fear the worst.
As you say. Very well. Very well. As you say. As you say. Very well. Cunning trap.
Blast!
It is begun. Shall be done. As you say, it is begun. Very well. I shall do it. Thank you.
Is that for me? Really? Wow! Wow!
If all were made tranquil, this would not have happened.
Thank you. That was an uncomfortable experience.
Expect more of those, because just thinking about the Fade sets my head spinning.
Very well. I shall do it.
It is time for supper.
Yes, my love.
What are we having tonight?
Roast pork. Your favorite. And candied yams. The meal looks sumptuous.
You spoil me, my sweet. How fare our children at their lessons?
You should ask them yourself.
What have you learned, my son?
Mother has me practicing my penmanship. She raps me on the knuckles if my letters are not for me.
Yes, a young man to be able to. What about you, my son?
Mother is teaching me to play the harp, and I helped with supper.
Well, it is delicious. Thank you, my dear.
Isn't this wonderful, husband? Isn't our life perfect?
Yes, it is all perfect.
Everything is just as you wanted, my knight. Our love and our family is more than you hoped for.
Do you hear something, love?
It is nothing, my darling. Just the door. I will get it. The children have finished supper. Tuck them into bed while I see who it is.
Don't be long. The children will want to kiss you goodnight.
I will be but a moment, my pet. You are intruding upon a loving, intimate moment, and I dislike disruptions. Happiness is bewitching. There is a certain power in all things mortals delight in. I have given him what he always wanted. Where is the harm in that? All emotion is intangible. You cannot see it, cannot grasp it.
But it is normally caused by something real. Real events, real people. What you've done to him is abhorrent.
I saw his loneliness and longing for a family that loved him.
A family where the wife and children are in reality the same person thing. That there, that defines creepy.
How long will you keep him in this stupor? Will he know it when his body fails and death claims him?
A short, blissful existence is preferable to an interminable one of misery. What happiness? He has gone through life empty, resentful of his vows. You would return him to this? I want nothing from you. I have what I need. All I ask is that you leave us alone. Then you leave me no choice.
Help! There are bandits at the door! They're going to murder the children!
They will not get past me!
These things have unusual powers.
trap!
I shall do it. Very well.
Involved. He's just resting. Poor lad. He was so very, very weary. You want to join us, don't you? Wouldn't you like to just lay down and forget about all this? Leave it all behind.
Can't. Keep eyes open. Someone. Pinch me.
Resist. You must resist. Else we are all lost.
Why do you fight? You deserve more. You deserve a rest. The world will go on without you.